Hello, today I'm going to teach you how to mask a photo. If you're looking for like a 2 minute or, you know, click the select button, this is not that video. This is going to teach you how to mask a photo manually so that you can make sure you get every single line for this. Just open for us. Now that I'm signed on, I'm going to go to Window, Workspace, and I do like the Essentials, so I'm going to reset it. This is just kind of how I set up my screen here. Okay, we're going to unlock the image. I come from a print background, so I have a whole flow of how I start this process. First, I always make sure my resolution is 300. Of course, unclick the resample. Sorry about that. All right. So now that image is ready to be masked and at the size it needs to be printed. So normally, if you hit Command Shift A, that's going to open some camera raw editing levels for you, and you can come in, and if you need to edit these, you can. So for me, like, I feel like this is kind of a bit yellow, so I might just put in a little blue into it. Too bright. Okay, so I'm just brightening up just a little bit so we can see some more detail of this. We're just going to pretend like the product today is the saddle. So that's what I would do. I might even add a little bit of level. So Command L to open my levels. I am working on a Mac. And just a tiny bit kind of gives it a little bit more pop. All right, so from here, I'm going to start masking. So I'm going to come get my pen tool. And to be honest, once you kind of master the pen tool, it'll help you in all kinds of different programs in Adobe because of the understanding the anchors. And so what I'm doing right now is putting down my first anchor, and then I've been doing this for a while, so I can tell a lot of people when they start, they do like this, they just do all these little, and you don't want to do that. So what I'm doing is I know that I can put a curve here, so I'm going to probably, my next anchor will be about here, and see, if you click and you let go, it's going to create a line, and I don't want a line, I want it to curve. So I'm going to click my mouse. I'm holding down my mouse. I haven't let go. And then now I can create like this, you know, the bow, and I have the arms now in the anchor. And so I'm pulling on those arms. All right. So from here, I'm going to hold option while my finger is still holding down the mouse and bringing down this handle, excuse me, it's handle, bringing down this handle. Okay, go to the next one. And then there's some places, like if I feel like I want to get a little bit closer, just so I can make sure I'm getting in there better with the detail, Command plus plus will help me go in. Just clicking along. And this does take some practice. Like I said, I truly believe like once you get the hang of working with the pen tool, I feel like that's like, it opens up so many possibilities for you. There's handles and a pen tool and Illustrator. You also have handles kind of like this in After Effects. I kind of really feel like the pen tool is used pretty much everywhere with Adobe. I'll probably speed it up from here. So if you mess up, just Command Z will take you back or delete that line that you did. And then again here, because I don't want it, I understand that it's gonna not create the line I want, so I'm bringing in that handle. Right here, you need to close it. So let go, right click, make selection, and the radius feather, I always do 0.5. I've done this for years. It just kind of brings it in just like half a pixel, and then you hit okay. And then on your layers, you're gonna come down here and click on layer masks. All right, so now we're gonna look picture as a whole, and we're going to want to clean up like this area here. We'll take that out. I think that would be it. And then so we'll zoom in. Re-click, make selection. Hit OK, and then you're gonna get your paintbrush. All right, and you see here, like we want to make sure to see it's on white. If we were to hit the white, it's not gonna do anything. So we wanna make sure it's on the black. And I always turn my hardness down. We're gonna make this a little bit smaller. That's good. And make sure your opacity is at 100, so you're just going to go in and it's like, you know, like paint or color it out of there. Okay. And then you're going to hit Command D, and that's going to take away the ants. And there you have a masked product or image.